So in this video, I'm going to run through our Dante Onramp feature that's available on our Dante Connect Series amplifiers, and I'll show you how to share our analog input signals from one amp using Dante to another amplifier. So to start off, our Dante Onramp feature is a really great feature. Of course, you do need the Dante Connect Series amplifiers for this to work. So on the top here, I've got a 354D, and on the bottom here, I've got a 168D. So with Dante Onramp, what happens is the analog inputs get shared into the amplifier, so they go into the input matrix for the output channels, and they also get sent to the Dante transmitter on the built-in Broadway card. So what that allows you to do is take your analog inputs and then route them via Dante to share with other devices. So what we've got here is a signal coming in on analog input 1 and analog input 2. Those are assigned to channels 1 and 2 of the 354D here. So the easiest way to share those to the other channels on board the amp is obviously go into the input matrix, and we can just select analog 1 and analog 2. So now these are going to all four channels of this amplifier. But now to get those input signals to the 168D, we're going to use a Dante controller. So I've already got that open here, and what we're going to do is route the 354D transmitter 1 and 2, which already has the analog input 1 and 2 on them, and we're going to route that to the receiver of the 168D. So we're going to do that here and make these connections. We'll do transmitter 1 to receiver 1 and transmitter 2 to receiver 2. So now I can come back to the web UI here, and we go into the 168D. So now instead of having the analog inputs set for each channel, we're going to go in and we can change these to Dante input 1 and Dante input 2. Of course, we can also do summed, so Dante input 1 plus 2, so say these are monozones. And we can do that on all 8 channels of this amplifier. So now those analog input signals are shared between both amplifiers via Dante. However, you may have some time sync issues with these signals, as there is a little bit of latency once you go into Dante compared to the analog signals. There is a way that we can correct this, though, and keep everything in time sync. So what we're going to do is go back to Dante controller, and what we can do is route the transmitter from the 354D back to the receiver of the 354D. So if we can make those connections here, so transmitter 1 to receiver 1 and 2 to 2, now everything is going to be sent to both amps in Dante. So if we come back to the web UI, we go back to our 354D, and instead of having the analog input signals here, we're going to change these to Dante input 1 and Dante input 2, or Dante 1 plus 2 on these other channels. So now you have the same analog input signals coming in. They're being converted to Dante through our Dante Onramp feature, and now everything is being sent to both amplifiers via Dante, so it's all in time sync. So this is really great to share analog input signals from one amplifier to another if you don't have a separate DSP processor in your system. It's also a great way to expand a DSP. So if you have a Dante-enabled DSP processor, you've run out of analog line-level inputs, you can use the analog inputs of the amplifiers to expand the inputs on your Dante-enabled processor or any other product. So lots of applications here. It's a really great feature. Go have at it, use it, and let us know what you think.